Okay, what I'm doing right now is I've got the cutouts for my handles for the drawer fronts, and you want to do this before you assemble the drawers because it's very difficult to mess with this once the drawers are assembled. So you want to go ahead and make your cutouts first. And the way I'm going to do this is I'm marking the I'm just marking right now with my assistant's help. I can't get anything done unless I'm being licked. So let me see. So what I'm doing is I'm just marking. So, I mean, I could do this with the router, but that's too much routing. That's too much dust. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to drill a 1¼ inch hole on each one of these marks right here. Just quickly do it on the drill press. And then I'm going to connect the tangent of those circles with the jigsaw. Doesn't have to be perfect. It's just going to be a cutout, and then after I get that done, I'll shape it real quick with a rasp and kind of straighten it out if I wasn't nice and straight. And then I'm going to take a good roundover bit, and I'm going to come in and I'm going to round it over inside and out so there's a softness to that handle. But I want to have two handles on this because the drawer is so big. Plus, there have been some times when I've taken a whole drawer out of my other work table filled with tools, two of us carrying with the handles cut out on it, and just put it on my trailer or in the back of my truck. So just in one fell swoop, take all the stuff that I need to go to a job site, load it up, just slides right out, and at the end of the day, when I'm done, undo it, slide it right back into my table, and then put it all back to its proper place later. But the smaller drawers, they're just gonna have one cut out. But I always mark these on the inside so I don't get confused on the outside and actually make the drawer on the wrong side. So after my slot is cut, I know I can keep that straight. But I like to just give myself a little spot for that Forstner bit to find on the drill press. Okay, I'm going to go over to the drill press and drill these out. And like I said, I'm not that worried about busting through the back. I will have a backing plate on here, but since I'm going to round it over, if I bust it out a little bit, plus, like I said, you know, these are shop drawers. These are not furniture. These are shop drawers that are going to end up having dirty, gross tools put in them, and things beaten up against them, and things clamped to them, and so you gotta just know which battles to pick. And so if a little bit of bust out happens on the side, you know, it's okay. We're not making anything fancy here. We're just trying to make something functional and strong that'll last. Okay, I'm going to the drill press. I don't know how many of these boxes I have, but I have a bunch of them. So every time I would do a big batch of drawers, I'd whip up a bunch of boxes, and they're just the most versatile thing for just building and assembling on, cutting on. So this is just a box that I had cut a hole in the side, and I use it all the time. So I cut the exact hole with a circle cutter. So with this thing, it's a compass that has this cutting tool on it. You can create custom holes of just about any size within this range. And so I just made a hole that was the size of my dust collection snout. So that just fits in here. And now watch how efficient it is when I route the, when I cut with the jigsaw up on top here. So I've got the tool trigger hooked up to my jigsaw. Because a lot of times, you know, this has a very cool dust collection system where it has this plastic cowl, but I can't see what I'm doing with it. So this just works really good. Watch how efficient it is. And I learned a long time ago that these bimetal blades, the ones that you use for cutting steel, if you cut your jigsaw back to zero and put these bimetal blades in, you just get such a nice cut, and the blades just last forever. They don't rip out and make as nasty a cut as a lot of these aggressive wood tooth blades do. So I really like them for woodworking. So when I drilled my holes, when I laid this out, I thought, I said earlier that I was going to use a 1 1/4 hole, but I realized that was too big, and I looked at my other one. So this is a 1, so I have changed that. I have changed that in the, you know, from what I said earlier. Let me cut another one of these. So all I did is I just drilled my holes to my crosshatch marks, and then I just completed the line to the tangent of these circles. See, the other nice thing about these boxes is that you put the box up on top of your work table and then your workpiece on top of the box, and it just gets it up higher, you know, so you don't have to bend over. I'm 52 and a half years old, and my days of stooping are over. I just cannot stoop over stuff the way I used to. So anytime I can bring the workpiece up to a comfortable height where I can see what I'm doing without having to stoop down is, you know, that's just what that's just what I do. I cannot stand it. I won't do it anymore. I can't do it. I won't do it. I can't do it. Put that there and it'll create better suction. After your jigsaw work, I just take this Nicholson 49 and just kind of straighten things out, kind of fork these corners out a little bit with these transitions. You don't have to go crazy, just a little bit, just so the router doesn't follow. That's good enough. And it doesn't matter, like I said, this is going to be okay because we're going to route over that. And my convention is I always do the outside first. So I have my router set up on top of this my vacuum box here, just this simple box with a hole cut in it. I've got this. It's a 1 inch radius, so it's really the inappropriate size for this, but I use the a half inch radius. I have a 3/8, but it wasn't big enough, and so I needed some intermediate because this material is about 7/8, but I didn't have it, so I'm just going to make this work, you know, just for these drawers. That's a nice soft look here. Just to, you know, when I'm sanding this, I'll just reach inside here, you know. I mean, I'm not going to do much. I'm just going to hit it inside with a little bit of fabric-backed paper just to soften these edges just a little bit more. But this is going to be fine for a work table.